It's not that kind of show. Don't get excited. It's all okay. I'm at 9:45.
These things happen all the time. Well, not all the time, but...
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the size too much. This dance, actually, so we're going to take you to the back of the stage here. We've got Hungary. This is a picture of Hungary before World War I. The entire area there. If you've actually noticed, inside there's a kingly shape, which entitles the New Hungary, and that's what it looks like today. The dance that you just saw was from Transylvania, the Romanian side, and that's really where that comes from. So there's a little bit difference, more of a gypsy-style dance,
yep.
Which is basically, when the instructor came out, he went to the village, he learned the dance. So this is a professional Hungarian dancer, comes out, learns the dance in the village, spends the time, eats with them, drinks with them, has a good, and just enjoys what they do, and then learns a dance, literally flies to us. I don't know if you remember this, but he comes off the airplane and he literally starts teaching us.
There's no wasting time. And I don't know if you noticed, but I can attest to, particularly for the women, that's one of the more challenging dances for the footwork for the women. A lot of other dances are still very uplifting and bouncy, but a lot of kind of precise, intricate footwork in there for the women, so it adds that extra challenge, for sure.
The ultimate goal of that particular dance is to go bang and then leave.
Yeah.
That's really what it comes down to.
That's right. Okay. So, my name is Sylvia Horvath, and...
I'm Frankie Sinigi. We will be your MCs for the evening.
Thank you so much for coming tonight. Welcome to Folkorama. And our next number for you is coming from our intermediate dancers with the...
Ravakuzi, which you're going to notice on inside of the map, this will be your southern western tip area of Hungary, inside of that kidney over there, our kidney bean. And so that's opening. So you're going basically all the way from the east side now over to the more west side. Ladies and gentlemen, the intermediate dancers.
Come on, come on.
and gentlemen, the Intermediate Capistrano Folk Ensemble performing the Boogie. So we have another great dance that we've got coming up here.
Yes, it is called the Shomu Di Kuvegesh, or the Bottle Dance.
Yes, and the men's dance. So I learned this year.
Yes.
There's a men's bottle dance and a woman's bottle dance.
That's right.
They're
that's
a little different though.
Yes, absolutely. What makes it different is that the men tend to dance around the bottles with the bottles on the ground, basically. The women, though, balance the bottles on their head to showcase their balancing skills and to attract the attention of the men. So a little bit of a different skill level there, I think. We may even have the opportunity for some people to practice, maybe.
Ooh, try that? Okay,
that
sounds good.
I think we might welcome our intermediate and senior dancers with Uvayash.
Shakara chadava.
All right, now girls, don't go too far. You guys have a job to do. We are looking for some volunteers. If we don't have volunteers, then we'll get some people recruited to practice some balancing skills. All right, so who would like to come up on stage and try their balancing skills? Yeah.
You've all been told.
That's right. While these girls are recruiting some volunteers here.
In the meantime, we're going to bring up to our youth, our adult guys.
It's okay, Frankie. You can join me.
Yes, she
is. Show so far. I am Michael Graham, one of the adult ambassadors. This is my wife, Christelle Graham, the other adult ambassador.
Hi, I'm Quinn Gobank, and next to me here is Sarah Graham, and we're together, we are the youth ambassadors for the Pavilion.
Fantastic. Thanks very much for coming up, guys. They represented us very, very well last week. They went to every single 20, all 22 of the pavilions, and did us proud.
All right. We also have a group with us tonight from Syngenta, Canada.
Syngenta!
Yes. All right. A big group of you guys from Ontario, Manitoba, and Saskatchewan. Thanks so much for joining us today. So, all right, we've got some people here. So, you guys are going to try and balance this bottle on your head. It does take some practice, but it is, as you can see, very possible.
Should do video or still?
So girls, you can give them some pointers, right? But it's all about keeping your head and neck still while you move your body.
Okay.
Right, there we go. Okay. So there's that static control. And if you feel comfortable, try taking a couple of steps forward, maybe. There you go. See? Wow. Awesome. Great job, you guys. Look at that.
Spin around.
Oh, see, they're there to help you just in case. Great. I'm going to try walking backwards. All right.
And heels over there as well. That's impressive.
Now, how about one more? Can you spin once? Can you go as slow as you wish? Look at that. And she's in wedges. I honestly have never done it in wedges before. I have not done that.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
Great job, guys. Awesome.
Very, very nerve-wracking when you think about it. You put that bottle on. So we were talking about this last show in regards to who actually and how people have done. Well, I think I've probably been one of the only people that's ever smashed one of those bottles. I tried it myself in our last pavilion that we had. I was standing right around here, and the fortunate part was as I was moving, the bottle bounced, and we had some over there. And it went shattered. So it was I've never done that again.
That's never happened to me.
No,
it's never happened to me. Yeah, no. It's never happened to me, I'm just saying. All right, for our next performance, it's our intermediate dancers with the
Rabakazi. This is, you're going to notice with the beautiful aprons that the men are wearing, this is something where the men don't necessarily use the embroidery as much as women do. And so in this particular case, when you look at actually where their aprons, those are all hand embroidered. They're all done in the village. These are all brought in from Hungary, so they're absolutely beautiful.
And again, some more uplifting style of music for you. Please welcome our intermediate Kapistran dancers. Thank you.
And so I'm just going to ask, we have Gabby Neary here. So Gabby, tell me a little bit about your hair. So this is actually quite unique in regards to the way that it's set up. So let's talk, how long did this take to put in?
It took like a few minutes. It took longer. Long, but it kind of hurt.
The sacrifices we make.
You betcha. Thanks so much, guys. Take care. So it's interesting. So each and every single region, it's interesting because, like I said, with Hungary, it takes 8 hours to drive from the west side over to the east side, and yet every other little area has got such a unique, different piece to it, which is
absolutely
so neat. So that's something. So the other thing that I wanted to bring up, Sylvie, so we had been talking about this.
That's right. So
how do you starve a Hungarian? You know this?
Have you heard this? No, I have not.
Yeah, I've heard this one. So how do you start Hungarian?
Don't give them paprika.
Don't give them paprika. That's the way it goes.
Yes,
so
that one.
This is what we're known for, is ultimately not only the goulash, but what makes goulash so special is a paprika.
And almost every other Hungarian dish.
Pretty much, right? And this is really what adds it, whether we put it with a uborka salata, which is our salads, or anything like that. And so Sylvia had actually noticed something special about the stuff that we have here versus what you'll find at a typical delicatessen or somewhere else.
Yes, if you look at the color of it, and I don't know if you can appreciate this from the stage, but if not, you can always take a look at it in our marketplace. But the color is quite a rich, bright, orangey red color. If you bought this in a store locally, it tends to have more of a dull kind of orange color. So the quality of the paprika is just a little bit different coming straight from Hungary. It might have like a slightly different taste to it as well. But that is available in our marketplace if you're interested.
And also the only thing that has more vitamin C is an orange. So this really is a very, very, it's actually very nutritious, which is another key piece to what we're able to bring to the table. Next to the Rubik's Cube.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
You like that? Oh, is that good?
So our final number for you tonight is called the Bükkeni. So it comes from Szabolcs Szatmár in the northeastern part of Hungary. What you're going to find with this one, it tends to be a crowd pleaser because of the uplifting music, lots of boot slapping, and just generally a very sort of happy, sort of high energy, happy ambiance in general. Thank you so much, Alex, for that. Welcome our senior Kapitra dancers. Thank you.
ensemble. You know, kids, in the last bit of time, I've seen Robbie Boo. Robbie Boo, well done, my friend. Well done.
He has no idea what he's talking about.
Ladies and gentlemen, it was an honor. It honestly was. It was a pleasure to have had you join us this evening. We have a band in from Hungary that flew in here. They landed here on Sunday evening at 10:30. They're putting it together. They're able to put together something, putting together live music and dancing. I hope we were able to show you the passion and the enjoyment that we truly had.
Absolutely.
You could go anywhere in the world and you chose to come to our little country.
So thank you so much for joining us on your tour of Folkorama. Jó estét kívánok mindenkinek, so have yourselves a good night. Thank you so much.